This video is called Right Triangle Trig 5. It's the last video for your notes tonight. There's two more problems left. Again, it's practicing looking at your triangle, picking the correct trig function, setting it up correctly, and hopefully being able to use your calculator to solve and get the right answer. So here in this case, it looks like we're going to go from the perspective of the 32, which means the 30 is my opposite and the x is my hypotenuse. And SOHCAHTOA would tell us that this is a sine, because sine is opposite over hypotenuse. So to set up your problem, you're going to have the sine of 32 degrees equals the opposite, which is 30, over x, which is my hypotenuse. So this would get me partial credit on a test by setting this up correctly, and then you will earn the rest of your credit by solving it. Again, don't let the fact that the x is in the denominator make you nervous. Just simply do the process that you're used to get this x alone, or to get rid of the fraction, you take whatever's in the denominator, multiply both sides. So on the right-hand side, the x's cancel, and you're left with a 30. On the left-hand side, you have x times the sine of 32. So to get the x alone, we've got to move that sine of 32. Since it's multiplying the x, we'll do the inverse and divide. So we have 30 divided by the sine of 32, which gives us 56.6. If your calculator doesn't give you that, you'll still need some work on punching things in. It's very important that you can do that, so make sure you get some help. And then lastly, problem 21. It looks like we're going to go from the perspective of 17, where 57 would be my adjacent, and x would be, not my opposite, excuse me, but it would be my hypotenuse. If you look at SOHCAHTOA, you can see cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse, so it's important you pick the correct trig function. In this case, it's cosine. So our setup will be the cosine of 17 equals the adjacent, which is 57, over the opposite, which is x. So now again, to solve this, since you take whatever's in the denominator, multiply it by both sides, the x's cancel on the right, you're left with 57. On the left, you have x times the cosine of 17. So to get the x alone, since the cosine of 17, sorry about that, since the cosine of 17 is multiplying the x, we'll do the inverse and divide. The cosines of 17s on the left cancel, and when you do 57 divided by the cosine of 17 in your calculator, you get 59.6. All right, so hopefully you're getting comfortable with looking at a right triangle, going from the perspective of an angle to solve for a side length x. You can pick the correct trig function, set it up correctly, and hopefully use your calculator to help you arrive at the right answer. Good luck.